So we had this unusual childhood being in that church, and also we had a big fluctuating family. My mom and dad, they over the years, and they still do, they took in a lot of little kids who were from rough backgrounds and tough situations. And it was a glorious childhood, though. It was good. You know, we were poor, but we never went to bed hungry. I would never complain about anything like that. You know, there were 6 to 10 kids. I don't really know how mom did it. I do actually know how she did it. She never went shopping until she had a fistful of coupons the size of a bad Uno hand. And she saved most of her money on breakfast, because she fed us oatmeal day after day after day. She bought oatmeal in 50-pound bags. I can still see it out there on the porch, and I'll never forget. I signed my first book deal, and I got to go to New York City and meet with my agent and my editor, and they took me out to a very fancy restaurant for a breakfast meeting. And I still remember sitting down, and they said, "Get whatever you want. Get what." And they have steel-cut oatmeal. I said, "Yeah, well, I'm having waffles." And I guess she'd do her best, I mean, to break it up. On Thursdays, every once in a while, we got cornmeal mush with molasses in it and a little pat of butter. That was living. And on Fridays, also, I've just remembered, on Fridays, she would let us put, I think it was somewhere between 7 and 9 chocolate chips in our oatmeal. And basically, you just stirred it and it became faintly brown. And then one time, she was really trying to save money, she found out that carob chips were cheaper than chocolate chips. Yeah, that's the only time my mother ever lied to me. She said, "Oh, they taste just like chocolate." "No, they don't, Mom. I don't know what they taste like, but it's not chocolate." And one year, she hit the bonanza of money-saving breakfast. Our next-door neighbor was a farmer, crop farmer, and he did what most of them did. It was either corn or soybeans. But one year, he planted a whole bunch of wheat. And so when harvest time came, he's out to his combining the wheat. My mom throws one of them 50-gallon plastic garbage cans in the back of the pickup. She drove out into his field, and she talked him into letting her take a whole bunch of wheat right straight out of his gravity box. 50 gallons of wheat out of his gravity box, and then for the next several months, she fed us boiled wheat for breakfast. So, the one time that we got to have box cereal, or as we called it, boughten cereal, we called it boughten cereal because she didn't steal it from the neighbor's gravity box. And it hardly ever had grasshopper legs in it. But she let us eat boughten cereal on Sunday morning. That was her one concession to economy, was in the interest of getting 6 to 10 kids ready for church by 9 a.m., we could eat box cereal. And this was a real, real big deal for us. And but even there, she couldn't just get it. This was the days before Sam's Club and Walmart, but there was a city near us where Mom would drive, and they had this great big giant steel warehouse. It was all dark and dingy inside, and that's where rejected food went to die. And it was this big discount warehouse, and she would come home with a van full of food from there. That's where she bought all of the cereal. And my brothers and I always said, we never ate a box of cereal that hadn't been backed up on by the truck that brought it. So I can't possibly explain to you what a big deal box cereal was. And so one day, my brother and I are at my grandma's house. We're watching TV. We didn't have TV because of the church we were in, but Grandma had a TV because she was a sinner. Plus, she smoked two packs of Carlton 100s a day, so that way wickedness lies. But me and my brother John, we was watching TV, and my brother John is one of these. He's been 72 years old since he was 4. So we're sitting there watching TV, and one of those total cereal ads came on. The one that goes, "You'd have to eat 12 bowls of Froot Loops to get the nutrition in one bowl of Total." And my brother John waits a minute, and then he looks at me and goes, "I'll take the 12 bowls of Froot Loops."